We are back. It's the Alex Jones Show. Of course, joining us is Alex Jones, and we're talking cybersecurity from the Cyber Bullying Act, which is just totally and completely being promoted by the media to the youth through Hannah Montana, and of course, the Cybersecurity Act, which is being promoted by Jay Rockefeller and others, and now the Obama administration just coming out saying, you know what, we're going to have a new bureaucracy, we're going to have all this control over you, we are building a smart grid, your medical records will be digitized. And earlier today, Alex, we played bits and segments of you going to SeaWorld and explaining this smart grid, this biometric control system.
Yeah, that was like 7 years ago, but none of this is, I don't deserve the credit for knowing about this. This has been all on record. MIT, the CIA, the Defense Department were writing 20 years ago, you'll be digital face scanned, thumbprinted to buy and sell. There'll be a global sales tax. There'll be a global carbon credit tax. And that it's designed to categorize everything we do, everywhere we go, to create a psychological algorithm. When you eat too much beef, you'll be given a special tax because it's all going to be on your record. When you drink, it'll be put on your record. But then when you weigh too much, already in Japan, I saw the article last week, bureaucrats come around, social services, all adults must be weighed by the government, and then they fine and fee you and make you go to these prison workout centers to be exercised. This is the nanny state, but it's to carry out eugenics. That's why they want social welfare system with the socialized health care. So when you have a heart attack, they give you an aspirin. Or when you have a brain tumor, you wait 18 months when it would have been operable in 2 months and you die 100% of the time.
Well, let's talk about that for just a second, Alex, because, you know, last night I'm up really late. It's like 3 a.m., but I'm watching the CBS national news feed, and lo and behold, there's a story out of Austin, and they're talking to this, you know, realtor, this woman who's a single mother of two, and she's saying, oh, it's so hard. We had to give up our medical insurance, but don't worry. The new medical vans are coming around town, and that's where I take my children now. It used to be just for lower income families, but since we all have to sacrifice, we're going to have to use these mobile medical vans where they're basically going to give you the delicious vaccinations and drugs that just dumb you down and enslave you.
Let me break that down. I kept telling people the FEMA camps are going to be a place you've got to go. It's not going to be, oh, here's the deadly FEMA camp. If you read the FEMA camp bill, everything in it is already built. It's just codifying it into law. You'll have over 100 small camps, 6 big regional camps. Every city has it. Robert Mueller has part of it built. The Highland Mall has part of the FEMA center in it now. And poor Austinites can't even go look at it for themselves. They just say, no, it's not true. But the point is, they're going to have, and as you said, this was on national news, but with Austin, the mobile vans, and they already have this for Head Start, where they come and say all your kids are abused, they drill out the wrong teeth, because they get more federal money for the more medical stuff they do. And they're going to have medical centers on these FEMA centers and trailers and tents, and people are going to want to live in them. But even if you want to live under a bridge or in the woods, they're going to make you go to them. This is all, see, I know what's going to happen because it's all stated. And that's why it started in Hawaii and California. We sent a camera crew there a month ago. It's going to be in the new Obama film. So that's why when I get on the air and I say, ladies and gentlemen, I cannot articulate to you how fast it's moving, how serious it is. I mean, here's one right here. Obama demands right to recruit minors for military because people don't want their 5-, 6-, 7-year-olds having recruiters in the schools federally and at all school districts brainwashing the kids to join the military and having them sign agreements to join. They tell them you'll be arrested if you don't. This when it's not the law. But see, they say you'll be arrested if you don't take vaccines. They say you'll be arrested if you yell at your kids now when it's not even the law. This is the system. This is a scientific tyranny. And yes, the Cyber Security Command. And yes, now that I'm down here, you know, taking a few days off, I'm watching more TV. Hannah Montana, that Cyrus demon, and her father, they are everywhere saying, turn your guns in. We need to ban the First Amendment because it makes kids commit suicide. Cyberbullying, which openly bans all free speech. I mean, openly bans it all. Federal felonies for any free speech that hurts someone's feelings. We've got to pass the Cybersecurity Command. This is a operation. I did do the research, by the way. It is confirmed. His whole family are in military intelligence and black ops. So this is definitely a giant psyop. And how do you argue with that? You know, your 10-year-old girl is allowed to watch TV. She watches the brainwashing. She wants to do what Hannah Montana is saying, and it's all about how she's going to be a movie star if she just believes in Hannah Montana, to destroy her morals, to take her away from your family. And the boys are doing the same thing. Folks, we have to come out of Babylon. We have to disconnect ourselves from the Matrix now before it's too late. We are under full assault. And
absolutely. It's not just about a backpack and a concert. It's about an agenda, a globalist agenda.
MySolarBackup.com. A lot of things can cut off your electrical power. Hurricanes, snow, ice storms, global warming, gremlins can chew off your electrical wires. A lot of things can happen. And so instead of sending all your money to Al Gore and carbon taxes, I suggest you take your own power needs out of the control of that control freak and go to MySolarBackup.com. The degenerate control freak, blood-sucking parasites of government, the New World Order, don't own the sun yet, folks. So make your move now. MySolarBackup.com, the great power source, 800 watts of power on demand. The solar panel, the system, the charger, the batteries, all of it. Great little system. Get a bunch of these, run your whole house. MySolarBackup.com, 877-327-0365, 877-327-0365.
We are back. It's the Alex Jones Show. We are, of course, joined by the man himself, Alex Jones, while he takes a well-deserved vacation. Alex?
Hermes, please stop calling me the man myself. And it's Alex Jones, introduced by the man himself, Jason Burmes, live 9 to midnight Central Standard Time on the one and the only GCN Radio Network. No, but seriously, you know, I keep making this point over and over again. I cannot articulate to the listeners how real this is, how fast this is moving, how hardcore this is. They admit they are building a complete and total control grid to where you won't be able to buy or sell, to where every farm, every ranch, even tiny gardens, and people that have five or six chickens and one rooster for eggs, that's going to be controlled. Bureaucrats all over the country, even in areas they've traditionally not been as aggressive, like Texas, are coming on people's property and saying, basically, you are my slave, you are scum. I mean, I'm sitting here in a cruddy cabin in Texas, taking a few days off with the kids, and it says, Protect the Planet, ProjectPlanetCore.com, and it says, report noisy leaks, faucets, and toilets. Turn off TV lights when leaving room. Reduce the AC heater when leaving the room. Turn off water while brushing teeth. Take short showers. Fill sink basin to shave. Participate in the linens and towels reuse program, which they don't even have here. American Hotel and Lodging Association. Now that's about telling you consuming is bad. That's about getting you ready to have what you can do micromanaged, as Nancy Pelosi admits. This is total slavery. But they go, oh, but it's for your own good. And the colleges are filled with nobody control freaks who are being given badges and guns as the new environmental green corps, backed up by the red and black jacketed thugs of Secure Corps, training with their M16s, not just dummy M16s, but real ones, according to the Philadelphia Daily News, to take on veterans, gun owners, and landowners. Every time I've been to urban warfare drills, they are practicing in Canada. This is on their news in Canada as well. Same with England. Taking on farmers and ranchers and mowing you down with machine guns. So when they say, oh, support the military on Memorial Day, it isn't our military anymore. That's how Hitler got the Germans to stand down and do whatever they were told, is he'd say, oh, support the military, Memorial Day. They had one of those in Germany. You know, you're not against the troops, are you? They pin everything they do on the red, white, and blue, the esprit de corps, our history, our liberties, our freedoms, George Washington. This is the opposite of George Washington and Thomas Jefferson and Sam Adams and John Adams. This is high treason. And there's no doubt this is tyranny. There's no doubt it's used against the general public. It's no doubt they're harassing citizens. It's no doubt they're using army intelligence to spy on mainline citizens' groups. There's no doubt the government's staging terror attacks. There is no doubt that they are setting up. They've already set it up. Look, there isn't wiretapping. The phone companies under the 1996 Telecommunications Act are set up to intercept everything. By federal law, everything is read. By federal law, they tear open your mail. By federal law, they urinate, and I'm sorry to use that term, all over the Constitution and Bill of Rights. This is about full-spectrum dominance is what the Pentagon calls it, and the Pentagon brags Thomas Barnett and others, their top futurists, that they openly work for offshore banks. They have conquered us. It is a big, sickening joke, but they can only continue their occupation if we're not aware that our government is illegitimate and criminal. Now, I'm going to get out of here so you can play the disgusting clips of the president out telling us about the new 2.0 Internet, which they, if you read the Internet 2 documents, they brag. Just type in Internet 2, the Internet is dead, and that's how they always start their conferences, with the government and corporations saying they're going to shut the web down, have Chinese-style censorship, now happening in England, Prison Planet banned in most government web systems and wireless systems in Australia and England. It's already happening here in the U.S. Ladies and gentlemen, it's over. The joking around is over. It's been moving incrementally, but now it's moving at warp speed.